Hello everyone, Dolphin Oracle here today, and touch base with you on a new app in MX14. If you've been running MX14 for a while, it'll come down with the usual updates. It's an app for all you users out there with Broadcom wireless cards, and it's called the Broadcom Wireless MX Broadcom Manager. You start it up with your root password, and what it's going to give you is this little screen here, and it's going to tell you what hardware is detected. Now, you guys looking at this video today are going to find that the screen's going to be square. So you're probably, if you're watching this on YouTube, you're probably going to see black bars on the sides. That's because I'm on an older machine and it has a 4x3 monitor, so that's what it looks like. It's not a trick of video. So you're going to see on the first tab, you're going to see hardware, what hardware is detected. And here's my Ethernet connection. And here's my wireless Broadcom BCM4321. Now, this is handy information because you can take this and you can do a Google search and always put the word Debian in there, and it'll tell you what drivers are actually used. I meant to have the web browser open. While it's opening, we'll take a look at this. If you plug in new hardware or whatever, you can click the rescan button, it'll unscan again. If you think you might have a software block, you can try this and it'll unblock all the devices, at least if it's a soft block. If you got a physical switch on your laptop, for instance, we can't help with a physical switch. So you can go to the Linux drivers tab once you know the hardware you have. And like I say, this tells you I have a BCM4321. So I'm going to Google here, or rather BCM4321. And always put Debian in the line because it gives you Debian specific information, which since MX is based on Debian, it helps. So we have the WL driver is actually supports my chipset, and that's actually what's running. I'm connected right now using the default WL driver, but I want to show you what happens if you're using an older chipset and maybe you got to use one of the legacy drivers or one of the open source drivers. WL is technically speaking a proprietary but free driver. It supports a wide range of cards and chipsets, but it doesn't support all of them. And the upside is it supports a lot. The downside is it doesn't support them all, and it actually conflicts with a couple of other drivers. So if WL doesn't work with your chipset, the other drivers don't load. Our system blocks them. So that's what MX Manager is all about. It's going to show you your chipset, and it's going to give you a list of drivers to try. Now, I already know that my chip, if you don't use the WL driver, my chip uses B43. I looked it up earlier, again, on the Debian site. This is actually a pretty good wiki here for that, and it tells me that 4321 is supported by the B43 driver, and it tells you what other chipsets support the other drivers. So what we can do, the first thing you have to do is you have to unload the current driver since it conflicts. You may or may not have to do this on your system if WL hasn't loaded. If it has loaded but it's not working, you need to unload it. So I'm going to click the and we'll select the driver and click unload. And you can see I disconnected from the network. Okay. And now I'm going to pick one of the blacklisted drivers, which like I said, I already know B43 works. And I'm going to click the load driver. Driver loaded successfully. Huzzah! And here I am. I'm connected back to my network once again. Is working just peachy keen fine. As you can see. Takes me right back to the Memphis Community MX website. So now I know that B43 is the working driver. Now I don't want WL to load in the future. So now we have a working driver and everything's working. We select WL and we click blacklist the driver. And now you'll see that it's added to the blacklist, and we have to unblacklist B43 because that's one we want to load the next time we reboot. So there we go. B43 is no longer on the blacklist. WL has been added. We're done. We click the relist. Actually, that doesn't do anything right now. So WL is unloaded. B43 is loaded. We're done. And my stuff is working. On the next reboot, the correct driver will be loaded. Pretty easy. Dealing with Broadcom is one of those things that tends to make Linux users in the world cringe just a shade, because it does tend to be complicated. Sometimes, some of you out there, it's not just for wireless, this B44 driver, which also conflicts with WL, unfortunately, is a lot of times used on Ethernet ports, on wired networking ports. So keep that in mind. It may be affecting your Ethernet, the WL may be working on your wireless, but then conflicting with your wired, depending on what cards and how your particular system is set up. We've got an all else fails kind of system for Windows drivers. It's an older system called NDIS wrapper. If you have a card that isn't supported by any of the open source drivers, and there are a few chips, particularly chips with five-digit names. I can't tell you one off the top of my head, but I have a USB stick that does not work with the open drivers. You can install NDIS wrapper, and this will help you load the Windows drivers. I'm not going to go through that. If you need to get that far, in my opinion, they do not work as well as the regular Linux drivers if you can get one of the Linux drivers to work. But anyway, you can click this button to install NDIS wrapper. You have to supply the driver to load the chip. It'll help you do that. And then Net Diagnostics, this is pretty cool. It'll tell you what your external IP is, what your internal IP address is. You can do some ping stuff and some trace routes if you need to do a little troubleshooting with something. So that's a pretty handy little tool. Nice option for you guys out there with the Broadcom chipsets that maybe have some conflicts going on. For tips, tricks, how-tos, head over to mxlinux.org or throw up a post at forum.mxlinux.org. This is Dolphin Oracle signing off. Have a great day.